Harper Audio presents You Need a Budget, the proven system for breaking the paycheck-to-paycheck cycle, getting out of debt, and living the life you want, by Jesse Mecham. This is the author. This audiobook comes with a free downloadable PDF containing a diagram included in the print edition, as well as the book's appendix. Please download the PDF from your audiobook provider's website. For Julie, and the six other small people who live in our house. Introduction. If you're listening to this book, money stresses you out in some way. For some of you, it might be pull-your-hair-out stress. For others, maybe you just know your money situation isn't as good as it could be. Whether we're panicking or just feeling uneasy, money thoughts interrupt our peace of mind all the time, on so many levels. We usually don't even notice it happening. You grab a $6 turkey sandwich at work, and while standing at the register, you think of the stack of cold cuts in your fridge at home. Should have gotten up earlier to pack lunch, you think. You read an article about how your generation isn't saving enough for retirement and wonder if you should up your 401k contribution. You save to remodel the bathroom and still worry it's the wrong move because your laptop is about to croak, the dog has a funny limp, and the growing rate of college tuition has us all thinking we should be eating beans between now and the time our kindergartners go to college. That tight feeling hits your chest, your breathing gets a little shallow, and you just chalk the stress up to your busy schedule. Those little stress daggers are actually the same question on repeat. Can I afford this? And this can be as small as lunch out with friends all the way up to retirement. The question haunts all of us all the time, whether we're wealthy or broke. We're always wondering if we can afford something. The only money question that rivals can I is its evil cousin, should I? This one is partly fueled by our competitive nature, but mostly by not knowing what we really want. A colleague shares that he puts something away for his kids' college every month, and you wonder if you should do the same. Your cousin Instagrams her family's epic Disney trip, highlights reel only, and you think, should I go on vacation? Should I? Always loops back to, can I? Keeping that anxiety bubbling so we know we need to do something, we're just not sure what, or when, or what we're even capable of. Most of us feel paralyzed by this point and end up doing nothing, usually for one of three reasons. We're not confident we know what is best. We're overwhelmed by options and have no idea whether to trust our gut, the guy yelling at us on TV, or something else entirely. We don't have a system for making decisions. I'll talk a lot about this throughout the book, but the bottom line is that we need a system in place to drive our decisions. Without one, we're spending and saving on whims. We're scared to learn the truth. Our finances are a black box. Money flies in and out of our accounts, and we guess we're doing fine because the balance never hits zero. But we have no idea what's truly going on, and we're afraid to find out. What to do? How can you break the paralysis with so many factors keeping you in neutral? That's what this book will help you figure out. And my first, biggest piece of advice may jolt you out of any financial impasse. Forget about the money. Seriously. Because it's not about the money. Okay, it's about money a little bit, but money is not the point, not the end goal. In truth, when we're stressed about our finances, it's because we're not sure our money decisions are aligned with the life we want to be living. The question we need to ask ourselves isn't, can I or should I? It's, what do I want my money to do for me? Answering this question will help us cope with endless options, pressure to keep up with the Joneses, and the paralyzing fear that we're just not being smart with our money. What do I want my money to do for me works like a gut check that helps us see whether our priorities are driving our money decisions. When we know what we want our money to do for us, the options become a lot less daunting, and confidence quickly replaces the stress. Gut check, go. what do I want my money to do for me? In all the time you devote to working, spending, saving, and stressing, have you ever asked yourself this question? Don't worry if you haven't. Most of us don't think about money in this way. And honestly, it's a hard question to answer. Not only that, but it's normal for your answer to change over time. That's why you need to keep doing the gut check with each money decision. It will either confirm your priorities or open your eyes to necessary changes. Let me be clear. What do I want and what do I want my money to do for me are different questions. I'm not prompting you to write your holiday wish list. What do I want my money to do for me is about nothing less than deciding what kind of life you want to live, and then making a plan so your money can help you get there. If you're not already living the life you want, how would you like to live instead? Don't worry if your answer is radically different from your current reality. Just think about what's important to you. Maybe the life you want involves staying home with your kids, annual European vacations, going back to school, or just less stress around bills. It could be all of those things. It doesn't matter. The point is to decide what your priorities are and then make a plan to meet them. Without a plan, you're floating and stumbling, hoping life will someday click into place. It's a lot like going to college and never choosing a major, maybe you did that, or going grocery shopping and grabbing random things on the shelf, hoping they'll add up to dinner, maybe you do that. This is actually how many of us treat our money. It just comes and goes without much thought until suddenly we are stressed. And we often don't even realize we're stressing about money. Everything just feels overwhelming. The antidote to your money stress. That little life plan? It's actually a budget. Yes, a budget. You need one. I need one. We all need a budget, no matter how much money we have or don't have. You picked up this book, so you probably already know that, but the idea of budgeting may still scare you. If you're worried it will be too rigid, restricting, and unforgiving, it's time to look at budgeting from a different angle. Forget about the things you can't do with your money, I can't afford that trip, or the things you have to do with your money, I have to pay off my student loans. Instead, think of what you want and go from there. I want to take my family to Italy. I want to live debt-free. I want to hire a personal tutor to learn Italian. A budget lets you plan for all of these things. I mentioned earlier that many of us struggle with money choices because we don't have a system for making decisions. Your budget is that system. It's a tool for designing your life around what you want. Without a budget, you have no way to prioritize your spending. You often don't even know where your money is truly going. You may stress about not being able to afford what's important to you while you simultaneously spend on things you'd willingly nix if you could see the trade-offs. That's the beauty of a good budget. It lets you see exactly how your spending affects the rest of your life. Perhaps that trip to Italy seems beyond your reality. Meanwhile, the takeout habit you barely enjoy costs you hundreds a month. You might fill your closet with eBay impulse buys you rarely wear while you cringe at your student loan balance. If you've been wondering how you'll ever afford to fill in the blank, you may not have to look as far as you think. This is what makes budgeting actually fun and liberating. There's nothing like the joy of zapping meaningless expenses and putting those dollars towards something that once seemed like a pipe dream. Imagine seeing your vacation fund grow while your waistline shrinks, double whammy, or seeing your student debt disappear as your clutter subsides. When the dollars stop leaving on a whim, you can make sure they fuel the things you do care about before they walk away. Your budget lets you spend and save guilt-free because you've already decided where you want those dollars to go. It helps you look at your money through a whole new lens so that you always feel good about your decisions, whether you're spending or not spending. This will play out differently for everyone. After taking a close look at your spending, you may decide takeout and eBay purchases are important to you, just maybe not as important as saving for Italy or paying off your loans. Whatever you decide, you can find a way to fund anything that, to you, makes for a good life. You just need a plan. Meet YNAB's four rules. This book will arm you with two very powerful and personal tools by the time you're done listening. A concrete system for making financial decisions tailored to the life you want. That system is your budget. A new mindset for looking at your money in ways you never have before. That mindset is YNAB's four rules. I'll spend the rest of this book unpacking the four rules and showing you how YNABers, that is, people who use YNAB, have used those rules to transform their lives. Here's the aerial view to start. Rule 1, give every dollar a job, is all about being proactive so life doesn't simply claim your money. Instead, you will decide on priorities first, then assign dollars, only the ones you have right now, we'll talk a lot about this, to those priorities before they walk off. Because your money is going toward your highest priorities, your spending has to clear a higher bar. Rule 2, embrace your true expenses, combines the power of thinking ahead with taking action here and now. Whether expenses happen like clockwork, rent, feel impossible to predict, car repairs, or are just far-off dreams, cash for a wedding, they are all part of your true expenses. The key is to prepare a bit at a time by treating them all like monthly expenses. Rule 3, roll with the punches, helps you adapt so you can handle whatever comes your way. Your budget is a plan, but plans change, and your budget should too. Spend more than you expected on dinner out with friends? Life throw you a curveball? No need for stress. Just pull some money from lower priority categories and carry on. You haven't failed at budgeting. You've adapted with the best of them. This flexibility isn't how most people imagine a budget, but it may be the key to making it work. Rule 4. Age your money gets you working towards spending money you earned at least 30 days ago. When you increase the time that passes between receiving your money and spending it, you're more secure, more flexible. You're breathing easier. If you're implementing the first three rules, you'll be aging your money before you know it, and you can officially say good riddance to the paycheck-to-paycheck cycle. Don't let the door hit you on the way out. These four rules work for anyone, no matter what your income level or goals might be. It doesn't matter if you're a recent grad navigating your first year of adulting or a retiree just starting to make withdrawals from your 401k, rich or poor, frugal or a spendthrift, the four rules will help you proactively engage with your money every day so you're in control of your finances. Before there were four rules, there were two newlyweds. I started You Need a Budget, YNAB, in 2004 because my wife, Julie, and I were desperate. We were 22-year-old newlyweds living in the 300-square-foot basement of a 60-year-old house. We were both students living on love. But love doesn't pay for your college tuition, books, or bus pass. Did I mention we didn't own a car? I was 3 years away from finishing my master's degree in accounting, so earning an actual salary was not in my near future. Julie was wrapping up her bachelor's degree in social work and began working for, wait for it, $10.50 an hour. On top of that, we were planning for our first child, and there was no way we could afford to live our dream of having Julie become a stay-at-home mom. I was feeling desperate, but as a numbers nerd, I knew I'd find the answer in an Excel spreadsheet, where all of life's magic happens. So, I began developing a system to help us track our expenses. My idea was simple. I planned to record everything we spent. Each of the spreadsheet's rows represented a day of the year. All of our spending and saving categories were lined up across the top. I had included the usual: groceries, textbooks, eating out, phone, gasoline, etc. The budget was beautiful to me in the way that any ordinary thing is always beautiful in the eyes of its creator. Julie and I stuck to using the budget daily, and after a couple of months, something surprising happened. Despite our meager financial circumstances, we realized we were doing pretty well. We could pay our bills and even put a little money aside. We still did all of the things that, to us, made for a good life. We budgeted for a few date nights each month, going out with friends, and a little spending money for each of us. We weren't living paycheck to paycheck, and we were hitting our goals. The budget had been working. So I did some thinking. If my budgeting strategies had worked for me, maybe they could work for other people too. At this point, we were eager to bring in more money so we could achieve our goal of having Julie be a stay-at-home mom. I started thinking that I could bring in extra income beyond my hourly intern work to give us even more breathing room as we transitioned Julie out of the workforce. My idea was to convince people that a budget would also...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.